of the advance payment, it's because we signed already an international contract. And under the international contract, if we will not, the payment of an advance payment is part or provided under the contract. And if we will not do that, then we will be penalized and the contractor will come after us. And maybe they may go to arbitration again, international arbitration. So we proceeded with the payment. Now, the question of COA regarding some technical issues. Mm-hmm. On several occasions, the DOTC prepared a reply already. And their question is very technical. And so we requested our PMO, our CAAP counterpart, mm-hmm. to prepare all these replies. And we made our replies to them. Mm-hmm. And so even me, I cannot answer all those questions mm-hmm. by COA because I'm not that technically capable to answer that. And it's the ANS or the navigational engineers who can reply to that. And they made already and submitted to us, and we transmitted it to the COA. And still, of course, COA have their own opinion. Mm-hmm. We replied already, and they have their own opinion. Now, so what will happen? There is, under the regulations, there are process to be undertaken. They issue the notice of disallowance, and the DOTC will prepare, or we are now preparing our reply to that notice, and it's in a form of an appeal that is to be prepared by our legal department.
Mm-hmm. Engineer Ortiz, who are the technology providers for the new system that you want to put up?
The primary technology supplier will be a French company. You know.
This is Tails?
Yes, sir. And then they will be joined by other companies like those in Germany, mm-hmm. which is Comsoft. Mm-hmm. And then in Austria, there is a Frequentist. It's a
consortium.
It's a consortium, sir.
All right. Now, I'd like to ask you to respond because Senator Jingoy Estrada had earlier also expressed his apprehensions about this air navigation system. And I'm just reading from a press release that he actually issued early this year, and I'm pretty sure you're still aware of it. He was questioning the record or safety record as well of Tails in providing technology to other clients before. And he was even noting that as per a Commission on Audit report, Tails was supposed to be banned from doing business with the Philippine government after reneging on a 1 billion peso deal supposedly for a distress system to be used for sea navigation in this country. Can you comment on that particularly?
Tony, can June comment on this because I'm not aware of
this. All right. Engineer
Pangilinan. Yeah. Actually, what the good senator is referring maybe or the other reports are referring is the GMDSS or the Global Maritime Distress Signal System Project. Mm. There was a contract before way back in late 90s between Thomson CSF and the DOTC. Mm. And there was a contractual issues between the two parties. Now, if we are going to follow the FIDIC rule or the FIDIC rule of contract, if there are contractual issues, it has to be brought to arbitration.
Okay.
However, the process was not undertaken. So the issue was left hanging. So as going back now, in the present time, we bid out the project and we let Thales, which is now the new company, we allowed them to participate because there was no case against them.
There's no case, but only a COA recommendation.
There was a COA recommendation, but there was no action before that was undertaken, or there was no black listing process undertaken
but
for
it's
the company.
True, but it's true that they did not fulfill their contractual obligation.
Well, it is a debate. It's still a debatable thing, I think,
uh-huh.
because no one rendered a decision on who is at fault in that particular occasion.
Okay.
Is it the government or is it the contractor?
So
it has to be decided yet.
Mm, so meron pa palang cloud of doubt over, well, thales pala, not tails, no? Thales.
Yes, sir.
And whether or not it does provide a safe technology, because it was also involved in another case on speed sensors for Airbus commercial jets. So marami pa palang questions about the safety record of Thales engineer.
You know, Tony, we're not speaking in behalf of Thales here, but
right,
rather we would like to talk about the documents that was submitted to us, and of course the knowledge that all the technical guys here knows regarding the firm. Thales is not a small company. They are a global company, and they are involved in several. In fact, I think 40%, if I'm not mistaken, of the aerospace around the world are the equipment or the systems are designed by this company. So, well, the TAATS of Australia, the one in Africa, in Asia, the one in Taiwan. So, regarding the specific project that was that you have mentioned regarding some Python tube, there was no clear findings as to who really was at fault in that particular incident. I check also that
so
through the
none.
Website and through the internet.
Okay.
And well, the aviation authorities in Europe did not conclude that it was really that particular equipment produced by that particular company was at fault.
All right.
So it is still they are still, I think, conducting investigation. Mm-hmm. Although the, if I'm not mistaken, the civil aviation in Europe advises that airlines may use other brands, something like that.
So you're saying that Thales was still in the clear in regards to the Airbus
case? There is no competent authorities that declare that Thales is not capable of delivering what they ought to deliver.
All right. Well, gentlemen, unfortunately, this issue seems to be more technically complicated than we have enough time for. But at the same time, I'd like to also thank you, Engineer Ortiz, Engineer Pangilinan, and Mr. Kime, for coming over to the studio and trying to explain some of the intricacies of these two. Well, not just intricacies, but I think also the political convolutions behind this air traffic control system.